I just believe that I was all displaced.
Previous videos and things and see how it's evolved. They're no longer amateur athletes who train three or four times a week and just do a generic class. They're now specific professionals who specify in one particular area and train in certain things. They do the gym work, they do sports psychology, they do biomechanical breakdowns of their movements, and they have plans. The introduction of money to the sport has definitely improved the quality, because now these people are actual professionals. It's what they do for a job. So they live, breathe and think the sport for 8-10 hours a day every day. As far as dealing with kids goes, they now take a very fun approach. Whilst when I was 6 years old, it was very strict. It was a process of elimination. You'd have 100 kids and 96 would drop out, but the four that stayed would be fantastic. Elite athletes, they're very, very specific. They will spend hours and hours and hours, hundreds of hours, perfecting one move before they try it in a competition scenario. So there's a whole bunch of different ranges they use for that these days. While it used to just be generic training, they have things like uchikomis on partners. They break down each scenario, whether it be a transition from standing work to ground work, from a throw to a strangle. They never do anything on the mat without a reason. Pretty much anything they do in competition, any step they take, they've practiced before, with often the intention of baiting somebody into doing something, so there's another outcome at the end of it.
Unlike it is in places like Europe, here in Australia we do not have the numbers to fight for hours on end, so we have to recreate and replicate small bits and steps of a fight as it would actually happen in reality. Judo is a very intense sport, and a high level of fitness is needed by all players, as fights can last up to 10 minutes long. The elite judo players are very aerobically and anaerobically fit, so they can fight at the higher level they do without getting tired to maximize their chance of winning.
Bill and Ben stuff. They walked out, got a hold of each other, and often there was very little research went into it. It would be put my skill up against your skill, and they'd go to training on each night of the week, and the coach would teach a generic lesson, and everyone in the class would do the same thing. So today would be a certain throw, and tomorrow would be a different throw, and then everyone might have a little bit of fighting at the end, maybe 20 minutes if they were lucky. I call it a 5-minute chess game, because not one thing happens without a reason for it. So the entire game, the entire 5 minutes is spent trying to create the ultimate outcome, which is an Ippon throw. So it's not a case of walking out there and just trying to dump somebody like it used to be. It's now a case of setting up the play, moving them where you want them, creating the bait, and then eventually, after 3, 4, 5 minutes, which an outsider might just think is all equal game, you're actually just laying the traps, and then when you're ready, that's when it all happens. Are you up for love?